And we continue tracking the tropics as we've got this invest to watch, because it does appear that this is going to bring a lot of moisture to Florida.
Yeah, meteorologist Kellyanne Class has been tracking this thing now for days. Kellyanne, it's still a little ways away.
It is, but it's going to quickly develop once it hits the warmer waters of the Gulf. Right now, though, over land, it's not really going to develop that quick. It's still very disorganized at this moment in time. And with that land interaction in Cuba today, no tropical depression, but tomorrow we could have a tropical depression. Once it moves into the straits, it's going to start to curve. A lot of the models signifying that it's going to hug close to the southwest Florida coastline and then potentially move into Tampa or even the Big Bend area and then cross into North Florida and then out into the Atlantic, where we'll hug very close to the Carolina coastline. And there it is expected to quickly intensify. So today it moves over Cuba. We're watching how it's going to interact with that land. Tomorrow, tropical depression is most likely going to happen as it gets closer to Florida. And then on Sunday, the system arrives. Heavy rain is going to be the biggest concern. We're watching, though, the wind and the severe weather threat. But look at how much rain we can receive in the next 5 days. A lot of locations around 3 to 5 inches of precipitation along the Gulf Coast, 5 to 7 inches of precipitation. So we're watching the flood threat Saturday. Flooding is possible across central Florida on Sunday, and we're watching the flood threat on Monday. Coming up in a few minutes, we'll talk a little bit more about the intensity of this system, and we'll also talk about the big time heat we have for today.